우현아 씨도 필리핀 가사 도우미에게 갑질을 했다는 주장을 하고 있습니다.
갑질 폭행 논란이 일었는데
갑질 논란
여자가 갑이다.
멘탈 갑!
어디서 갑질이야!
오케이 오케이 enough of that. What the heck is cop anyways? 안녕하세요. This is K-Water Bottle and today I'm going to talk about cop. So, cop is a single-letter word, and its origin dates back to 1700 BC of ancient China. And cop is the first letter of their numeric system called 천간. 천간 was used for measuring time, date, months, and so on. But these days, nobody in Korea uses cop for these reasons, so no need to memorize these. All you have to remember is that cop is the first number, and 을 is the second number. So this number 1 and number 2 can be used in the literal meaning like in this 사자성어 four-lettered idiom 갑론을박, which means the first person argues, the second person reputes, implying people debating. This idiom is commonly used in the news to describe, well, people debating over pro and con. But in most of the times, the number 1 and number 2 of 갑 and 을 are not used for their literal meaning, but used in metaphoric meaning, like number 1 as in the boss. This is originated from legal contracts in Korea. In Korean contract papers, 갑 is used for the boss, like employer or landlord, while 을 is used for employee or leaser. So for these reasons, these legal terms were turned into a meme, so 갑 and 을 on the internet, it's something like level 100 mafia boss and level 1 crook. Also, there's two uses for how we use 갑 on the internet. 갑 as in the boss, or 갑 as in power abuser. The former is usually used in this following form. You add 갑 in the end of something, and this means like the number one authority of that something. For example, 비주얼 갑 means the most good-looking person. 멘탈 갑 means the most enduring person or person who has best mentality. And sometimes we put 갑 after someone's name, and it's like calling someone lad or godlike. You get the point, right? Also, 갑 as in power abuser is mostly described with the word 갑질. So basically, when you add 질 at the end of a word, it means doing or using something with that word. For example, 톱 means a saw, so 톱질 means sawing. 바늘 means a needle, so 바느질 means sewing. 젓가락 means chopsticks, so 젓가락질 means using chopsticks. You get it, right? So 갑질 means abusing the power of being the boss. And as you can see, this kind of power abusing is becoming more common in Korea and being a huge society problem. But you still can use it like to your friend when your friend is bossing you around.
내일은 나 차 태워주고 오늘은 교통비만 좀 줘.
미쳤냐? 갑질하지 마. Okay, I think these are more than enough for you to understand the uses of 갑 in Korea. If you liked the video, why not leave a like or subscribe the channel for more of these contents? Oh, also, we have a Discord server for Korean learners. I'll link it in the comment section, so join us to discuss Korean culture, languages, and literally anything. Thanks for watching it through the end. 다음에 봐요.